All right, today I'm just gonna talk about matrices and hopefully clarify some questions up that people were asking. And I'll go through the PowerPoint at the end and go through each slide. So first thing about matrices is how do we classify? We classify matrices rows by columns. All right, so if I had a matrix, we need to figure out what's a row and what's a column. In a matrix, these are considered rows. All right, so in this example, I have two rows. We also need to state the columns because we do row by column. These are columns. All right, so I also have two columns. So this matrix is a 2x2. All matrices are not 2x2. Some matrices are bigger than others. Some matrices might have two rows. This is our first row. This is our second row. And they might have three columns. So in this matrix, we have a 2x3. We have two rows, and we have three columns. So this matrix is a 2x3. This matrix is a 2x2. So as long as you understand the basics of rows and columns, everything else is fairly easy. So let's just go through the PowerPoint right now. So on our first slide, all we talked about was the dimensions, which is what I just talked about, the rows and columns. Anything that is inside of a matrix is considered an entry or element. You can use either word, it doesn't really matter. So each one of these numbers is an entry. If you watched the YouTube video that I sent out, should have been fairly helpful for most people. Talked about entries, talked about how we classify them. It also talked about this example as well. So this matrix is labeled as matrix S, and they want us to find S12. So like I said, if you can understand rows and columns, you can find S12. So the first number always represents the row. Our second number always represents the column. So what this is asking us is, where's entry, first row, second column? So on this matrix, our first row is here. This is our first row. And our second column is here. So first row, second column is this entry here, which is equal to 9. So all I did was figure out what's my first row. My first row is here at the top. And I need to figure out where's my second column. My second column is here. So first row, first column is entry number 9. So that's the first thing that you have to do. Let's say that we wasn't trying to find S12. Let's say they wanted us to figure out what's S21. So if I was trying to find S21, I would look for my second row. So it's our first row, it's our second row. Second row, first column. Second row, first column is 15. So S12 is equal to 15. So those are fairly easy if you understand a row and column. We talked about dimensions. So one important thing about matrices is each corresponding spot is always equal to each other. So on our next slide, all you have to do is solve for the variables. So in this example, it tells us to figure out what these variables are equal to, right? So as I just stated, each entry is equal to one another. So this entry, 2x plus 4, has to be equal to 12. Just like 5 is equal to 5, 1 is equal to 1, negative 2 is equal to negative 2, negative 3y plus 5 is going to be equal to 5y minus 3, and negative 4 is equal to negative 4. So each entry is equal to each other, all right, they're equivalent. So I need to be able to figure out what these variables are equal to. Since I know these two entries are equal, I will set them equal to each other. So as I explained in the email, all we're doing is solving for variables, all right? So in order for me to get x by itself, I need to subtract 4 from both sides. These will cancel out. So I'm left with 2x is equal to 8. To get x by itself, I divide by 2, which means x is equal to 4. So now I figured out what this entry is equal to. My x value is equal to 4. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 plus 4 is 12. So this entry is equal to this entry. Now I need to figure out what y is equal to. So I would take this entry and set it equal to this entry. So second row, second column, second row, second column. So I got negative 3y plus 5. And it's equal to 5y minus 3. Now I got variables on both sides. I need to get rid of one of them. I'm gonna get rid of negative 3y. So I'm gonna add 3y to the opposite side. So 5 is equal to 8y minus 3. Now it's a two-step equation to be able to get y by itself. I add 3 to both sides, which tells me 8 is equal to 8y. And to get y by itself, I divide by 8, which means y is equal to 1. So like I said, in these examples, all we needed to do was figure out what our variables were equal to. X is equal to 4, y is equal to 1. All right, one important thing that we need to remember about matrices is to look at the dimensions. I know I didn't do it in the second slide that I just went over, but in this one, we look at our dimensions. In this one, we got two rows and we got two columns. So this is a 2x2. In this matrix, we have two rows and two columns. So this is also a 2x2. Which means each entry is equivalent to one another, right? So negative 3 is equal to negative 3. Negative 2x minus 3 is equal to negative 15. Negative 2 is equal to negative 2. 3y minus 12 is equal to negative 2y plus 13. So I need to be able to figure out what these variables are equal to. So if I look at this one and row 1, column 2, got negative 2x minus 3. Row 1, column 2, I get negative 15. So negative 2x minus 3 is equal to negative 15. To solve for x, I add 3 to both sides, which means negative 2x is equal to negative 12. To get x by itself, I divide by negative 2. Which means x is equal to 6. I need to do the same thing with my bottom entry. So row 2, column 2 is equal to row 2, column 2. So 3y minus 12 is equal to negative 2y plus 13. Again, I got variables on both sides, which means I gotta get rid of one. I'm gonna go ahead and add 2y to both sides, which gets me 5y minus 12 is equal to 13. Another two-step equation to get y by itself, so the first thing I do is add 12 to both sides, which means 5y is equal to 25. To get y by itself, we divide by 5, which means y is equal to 5. So again, all you needed to do in this example was solve for your variables. X is equal to 6, y is equal to 5. And the next thing that we're going to talk about this presentation is how do we add and how do we subtract matrices. In order for us to be able to add or subtract matrices, they have to have the same dimensions. Alright? If they do not have the same dimensions, you cannot add and you cannot subtract those two matrices. So in example 3, it tells us figure out what's A plus B and figure out what's A minus B. So the first thing that we need to do in this problem, for these two examples, is figure out the dimensions for both. So matrix A has 2 rows, and it has 3 columns. So this is a 2 by 3. Matrix B has 2 rows, and it has 3 columns. So both matrices in this example are 2 by 3s. Since they both are the same, that means we can add those and we can subtract those from each other. So to be able to figure out what's A plus B, all we do is add corresponding matrices, right? So on this one, I got negative 2, well, I'll write it out this way. So I need to add matrix A plus matrix B. So all I'm going to do is add corresponding entries. All right. So negative 2 plus 5 is equal to 3. So all I did was add first row by first column. Next thing I do is first row, second column plus first row, second column. 0 plus 7 gives me 7. And I do first row, third column plus first row, third column. 1 plus negative 1 gives me 0. Do the same thing with my second row. So second row plus first column, 5 plus 0 is equal to 5. Negative 7 plus 2 is equal to negative 5. And 8 plus negative 8 is equal to 0. So A plus B is equal to 3705 negative 50. Hopefully I'm not going too fast. First time making a video, so if I am going too fast, please pause it as you take notes. In example B, we need to do A minus B. So addition and subtraction is very similar. All we do is write out the two matrices again. So I got negative 2, 0, 1, 5, negative 7, 8, minus 5, 7, negative 1, 0, 2, negative 8. So all I'm going to do is subtract corresponding entries. So first row, first column, negative 2 minus 5. Remember, this is subtraction. Negative 2 minus 5 gives me negative 7. 0 minus 7 gives me negative 7. 1 minus negative 1, so I got two negatives. Remember, with two negatives, I turn into a positive. So 1 plus 1 gives me 2. 5 minus 0 gives me 5. Negative 7 minus 2 gives me negative 9. 8 minus negative 8, again, two negatives, gets me a positive. 8 plus 8 gets me 16. So our answer, once we subtract them, is here. Again, if I'm going too fast, please pause the video as you take notes and as you kind of comprehend what's going on. Yeah, I'm trying to make this video just to clarify some things for the students that had questions. Hopefully this explains a little bit better. Again, make sure you watch all of those videos that I sent to you. Covers the same exact thing. All right, so in this example, it wants us to add these two matrices. So the first thing that we do when we add or subtract the matrices, we look at the dimensions. In this first matrix, we have two rows and we have three columns. So this is a 2x3. The second matrix, we got three rows and we have two columns. So this is a 3x2. So right away we notice that these dimensions are not the same. If these two dimensions are not the same, we cannot add these two together. We cannot add these two together. All right, this next slide, they give us a combination of addition and subtraction, which is fine. We do the same exact thing. First thing we do is look at the dimensions. This has two rows and two columns. This is a 2x2. This also has two rows and two columns. So this is a 2x2. This also has two rows and two columns. So this is also a 2x2. All of these share the same dimensions, which means we can add and we can subtract these two matrices. So all I'm going to do is work left to right. Left to right. So I got my first two matrices, 3, 6, negative 3, negative 6, plus negative 4. I'm not doing anything with this one just yet, so I'm going to leave this up top. Yeah, when I add these two together, I'll bring this down so I can subtract. So first thing, 3 plus negative 4. 3 plus negative 4 gets me negative 1. 6 plus 5 gets me 11. Negative 3 plus negative 7 gets me negative 10. Negative 6 plus 8 gets me positive 2. So this was me adding the first two matrices together. So this answer that I got, I'm going to bring this down here. I'm going to write it in a different color. So I had negative 1, 11, negative 10, and 2. And I am going to subtract our last matrix, which is 0, 2, negative 10, and 11. So again, I am subtracting now. So I subtract corresponding entries. Negative 1 minus 0 gives me negative 1. 11 minus 2 gets me positive 9. Negative 10 minus negative 10, 2 negatives, gets me a positive. Negative 10 plus 10 gets me 0. 2 minus 11 gets me negative 9. So this is our final answer once we add and subtract these matrices. Again, if I went too fast, make sure you pause the video so you can take notes. If you got any questions, make sure you email me so I can kind of clarify some things as well. I believe this is our last slide that I sent out to you before we actually go in depth on how we multiply matrices together. Whenever it just tells us to multiply a matrix by a number, it's exactly what it said. This is telling me to multiply matrix A, this is matrix A, by negative 2. So all we do is multiply each entry of this matrix by negative 2, all right? So if I'm multiplying by negative 2, I get negative 2 times 3, negative 1, 2, 2, negative 3, 0, 0, 6, negative 2. Negative 2 times 3 gives me negative 6. Negative 2 times negative 1, well, I'll go across for each row. Negative 2 times 2 gives me negative 4. Negative 2 times 0 is 0. So I multiply my first row. Now I'm going to my second row. Negative 2 times negative 1 is positive 2. Negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6. Negative 2 times 6 gets me negative 12. Negative 2 times 2 is equal to negative 4. Negative 2 times 0 is equal to 0. Negative 2 times negative 10 is equal to positive 20. So this is my answer once I multiply matrix A by negative 2.